Hello dear children, hope you all are good and doing well. In my previous video, I have explained you about the terrestrial plant and their adaptations. In today's lecture, I am going to explain you about aquatic plants and what are different kind of aquatic plants and how they are adapted to their habitat. So let's begin with aquatic plant. Dear children, aquatic plants are the plants which grow in water. As aqua means water. So plants which are growing in water are known as aquatic plants. ऐसे पौधे जो पानी में उगते हैं उन्हें aquatic plants कहते हैं. There are three types of aquatic plants. Free floating, fixed floating and submerged plants. एक्वेटिक प्लांट्स बेसिकली तीन तरह के होते हैं. फर्स्ट फ्री फ्लोटिंग प्लांट्स जो पानी में तैरते रहते हैं. दूसरा है फिक्स्ड फ्लोटिंग जो बॉटम में जिनकी रूट्स फिक्स्ड रहती हैं वाटर बेड में बट वो पानी में रहते हैं. द सबमर्ज प्लांट्स आर द प्लांट्स विच आर कंप्लीटली अंडर द वाटर. सो देयर आर थ्री मेन कैटेगरीज. So one by one, I'll be explaining about these aquatic plants to you. So let's begin with the free floating plants. Free floating plants are small in size. These plants flow on water and are not rooted to the soil on the waterbed. इन पौधों की इन aquatic plants की size बहुत छोटा होता है और उनकी roots जो हैं वो waterbed से attach नहीं होती हैं. So basically their roots also float in the water. They are very light and spongy. Now these are the special adaptations which make them unable to float free in the water. Their spongy light weighted stems, their leaves and stems along with roots are filled with air spaces. इनके तने पत्तियों और जड़ों में एयर स्पेस होते हैं, हवा भरी रहती है जिसकी वजह से ये आसानी से पानी की सरफेस के ऊपर तैर सकते हैं और इनकी बॉडी लाइट वेट होती है. सो दीज आर स्पेशल अडेप्टेशंस. एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ सच प्लांट्स आर डकवीड, वाटर लेटस एंड वाटर हाइसिंथ. एज यू कैन सी दीज आर द थ्री डायग्राम्स. डकवीड यू कैन सी दे आर फ्लैट at the top and their roots or stem you can say these are floating in the water and size is also small. Here you can see in case of water lettuce their leaves are big in size but their roots and stems are very thin and are freely floating in the water. Here you can see water hyacinth. These stems are very light in weight and roots you can see they are floating in the water. So free floating plants are small in size. They have air filled spaces in their roots, stem and leaves and because of their light body they can freely float in the water. Their roots are not attached to the water bed. Next coming up is free floating plants, fixed floating plants. Fixed, as its name tells you, fixed means they are fixed to the waterbed. Fixed floating plants are rooted to the soil on the waterbed, means they are attached to the in whatever water body they grow, their roots remain attached with the waterbed or the underground soil. So these roots are fixed to the bottom of the pond. They have long hollow and lightweight stem which help them to float. See, they have very long cylindrical lightweighted stems and because of their light weight they easily float in the water but their roots are attached on the waterbed. These leaves are broad and flat. As you can see in the picture, leaves are broad in size and flat surface. They allow leaves to get enough sunlight and water. Because of the big surface of the leaf, maximum sunlight and air is absorbed by these plants because they are bigger in size. Leaves have a waxy coating on them. This is also a very special feature of these fixed floating plants. You can say a special adaptation which help them to survive in water and prevent their leaves to prevent them from rotting in the water. इनकी पत्तियों पर एक वैक्स जैसे सब्सटेंस की कोटिंग होती है जिसकी वजह से ये पानी में गलते नहीं है. दीज लीव्स हैव स्टोमेटा ओनली ऑन द अपर सर्फेस ऑफ द लीफ विच हेल्प देम टू ब्रीद ऑन द वाटर सर्फेस. यूजुअली लीव्स दे हैव स्टोमेटा ऑन द अंडर सर्फेस. आमतौर पर पत्तियों में स्टोमेटा पत्ते के नीचे सर्फेस पर सतह पर होते हैं, लेकिन फिक्स्ड फ्लोटिंग प्लांट्स की पत्तियों में स्टोमेटा इनके सरफेस के ऊपर वाले हिस्से पर पाए जाते हैं बिकॉज दे आर फ्लोटिंग ऑन द वाटर सरफेस. सो दिस इज अगेन अ स्पेशल अडेप्टेशन दैट स्टोमेटा आर ऑन द अपर सरफेस ऑफ द लीव सो दैट दे कैन ब्रीद वेल एंड एक्सचेंज ऑफ गैसेस कैन टेक प्लेस. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लीव्स आर हैविंग वैक्स कोटिंग विच हेल्प देम टू प्रिवेंट फ्रॉम रोटिंग. पानी में गलने से बचाती है वैक्स कोटिंग. और स्टोमेटा पत्ती के ऊपर वाले भाग पर होते हैं जिसकी वजह से पौधे आसानी से सांस ले सकते हैं. वाटर लिली एंड लोटस आर वेरी कॉमन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ फिक्स्ड फ्लोटिंग प्लांट्स. सो नेक्स्ट कैटेगरी इज सबमर्ज प्लांट्स. सबमर्ज मीन्स विच आर merged in the water. So underwater plants, or they are also known as underwater plants, means they completely grow under the water. Submerged plants grow and remain totally under the water surface. You cannot see them from the surface. They are under the water body wherever they grow, in lake, ponds, or on seabed. So these are again special kind of plants. They completely grow and retain under the water. The speciality of these plants is the root fix them to the bottom of the pond. Inki roots jo hain wo bottom se fix rehti hain and their stems are thin and flexible. Inke stem bahut patle hote hain, flexible hote hain. They are just like ribbons, very light in weight and ribbon like structure. See, this is one of the commonly seen underwater plant. Its name is tape grass. As you can see structure, their roots are very thin and they are very light weighted leaves and stems. Their leaves are in the form of a ribbon, very lightweight. They have long, narrow and tapered leaves which offer least resistance to water. Because of their this kind of ribbon like shape, they can easily remain safe under the water and they can bear the water pressure and the waves of the water because of their thin ribbon like structure. They don't have stomata on their leaves. This is again a special feature. Wherever other leaves they have stomata, this tape grass, they don't have stomata. Now question arises, how these plants, they breathe in carbon dioxide for photosynthesis? They breathe in carbon dioxide from their body surface and they breathe carbon dioxide which is in the water itself and breathe out oxygen. So they don't have stomata as such. They breathe through their leaf surface. They do not have stomata on their leaves and breathe through the body surface. ये अपनी पत्तियों के सरफेस से में छोटे छोटे होल्स होते हैं, उन्हीं से सांस लेते हैं. They use carbon dioxide dissolve in water for the photosynthesis and release carbon oxygen into water. This way they provide oxygen for the aquatic animal. So tape grass and hydrilla, they are very common example of such plants. So these are the three types of aquatic plant: fixed aquatic plants, floating aquatic plants, and submerged or underground aquatic plants. You need to learn their special adaptations or इनके एग्जाम्पल आपको याद करने हैं. कौन कौन से स्पेशल एडेप्टेशन है जो इन्हें वाटर, जो कि इनका हैबिटेट है, उसमें रहने के लिए हेल्प करते हैं. यू नीड टू लर्न ऑल दोज अलॉन्ग विद एटलीस्ट टू एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ ईच. नाउ एडेप्टेशन इन प्लांट्स फॉर प्रोटेक्शन, दिस इज अगेन वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग. सी लाइक अदर एनिमल्स एंड ह्यूमन बींग, everyone wants to be protected from the enemies. Same way, plants also need to protect themselves from their enemies. So what kind of special adaptation plants possess so that they can protect themselves from their enemies or someone who can harm them? पौधों को अपने आप को सुरक्षित रखने के लिए ऐसे कौन कौन सी adaptations, कौन से ऐसे special features उनके अंदर होते हैं जिनसे वो अपने आप को सुरक्षित रख पाते हैं अपने हैबिटेट के अंदर, अपने नेचुरल एनवायरनमेंट के अंदर. व्हाट आर दोज फीचर्स बाय विच दे प्रोटेक्ट देमसेल्व्स? सो वन बाय वन आई विल बी गिविंग यू टू थ्री एग्जांपल्स सो दैट यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड. जस्ट लाइक एनिमल्स, प्लांट्स ऑल्सो हैव एनिमीज. मैनी प्लांट्स हैव डेवलप्ड डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ एडेप्टेशंस टू सेव देमसेल्व्स फ्रॉम देयर एनिमीज. For the protection purpose also, they have some special adaptations. Like you have seen in plants, they survive in hilly areas due to special adaptations. They survive in desert area. They survive in heavy rainfall areas. They are adapted to grow in water as well. So, same way, for their protection, they have some special features. Some plants like the yam produce poisonous fruit or sap. कुछ पौधों में से एक खास तरह का liquid or you can say fruit juice निकलता है जो अपने आप में poisonous होता है. तो ऐसे में कोई भी human beings या animal उन पौधों को consume नहीं करते हैं because of their poisonous discharge. तो ऐसे बहुत से पौधे होते हैं जिनमें से इस तरह का एक जूसी सब्सटेंस और यू कैन से वाटर एक्सट्रैक्ट या एक्सक्रीशन निकलता है जो पॉइजनस होता है और इस वजह से उस पौधे को एनिमल्स नहीं खाते हैं. सो दिस इज़ हाउ दे प्रोटेक्ट देमसेल्व्स. सम प्लांट्स लाइक पम्पकिन एंड बैम्बू हैव फाइन हेयर ऑन देयर स्टेम एंड लीव्स. These hair cause itchiness which when touched. बहुत से ऐसे जो बेल पर उगने वाले पौधे हैं, जो खाने वाले पौधे जिनमें सब्जियां वगैरह हम इस्तेमाल करते हैं, ऐसे पौधों की जो स्टेम होती है उसके ऊपर कुछ बहुत छोटे छोटे से कांटे जैसे स्ट्रक्चर आप देख सकते हो, वो भी इसीलिए होते हैं ताकि उनको एनिमल्स ना खाएं. बैम्बू है, पम्पकिन है, पम्पकिन की जो बेल होती है, जो पौधा होता है जो कि एक क्लाइम्बर है, इसकी तने के ऊपर बहुत छोटे छोटे माइन्यूट कांटे से होते हैं. वो इसीलिए होते हैं क्योंकि अगर उसको टच किया जाएगा तो एक ख़ास तरह की इचिंगनेस होती है जिससे इससे दूर हट जाते हैं एनिमल्स और इस तरह से वो बच जाते हैं. सम प्लांट्स लाइक पाइनएप्पल, प्लम, रोज एट्सेट्रा, दे डेवलप थॉर्न्स. आपने बहुत सारे सुंदर फूल वाले पौधों में देखा होगा, स्पेशली रोज़ के केस में आपने देखा होगा कि उसमें कांटे होते हैं. तो उन कांटों की वजह से एनिमल्स और अदर यू नो क्रिएचर्स, दे डोंट हार्म देम. सो दीज थॉर्नी डेवलपमेंट्स, दीज थॉर्नी स्ट्रक्चर्स, दे हेल्प देम टू सर्वाइव. दीज थॉर्न कॉज इंजरी टू द एनिमल्स विच टच और ईट देम. So their thorns actually their protecting features. So this is how some plants, they adapt themselves or they protect themselves from their enemies. This is a yam plant stem. You can see here are some structures, and if you cut this, some typical kind of juice will come out, which is poisonous in nature, and that's why animal, they don't consume it. This is a pumpkin stem. You can see it's pumpkin is growing here, but here are some hair like structure which are very sharp and thorny in nature. So because of this, animal generally don't touch this. It's a rose plant. You can see thorns are here, and due to which animal don't harm this plant. So these are some adaptation which help plants to save themselves from the animals and human beings. So here is checkpoint 2. It's a practice exercise. Let's try to answer these questions. Fill in the blanks. Dash plant does not have stomata on its leaves. Hope you can answer which plant. Just now we have learnt. These are underwater plants. They don't have stomata on there, and they breathe through their body surface. So the answer would be underwater or submerged plants. They don't have stomata on their leaves. Dash is a plant with stomata present only on the upper surface. These are the fixed floating plant, and lotus and water lily are the example. Dash is an aquatic plant which is not rooted to the soil on the waterbed. These are free floating plants. Free floating plants are like water lettuce is an aquatic plant because it is free floating and their roots are not attached to the waterbed. Now some new words which you have learned in this chapter. You need to learn these words or definitions by heart. These are habitat. It's the natural place where plants naturally grow. It's a natural home of any plant, or you can say the place where plants naturally live is called habitat. Adaptation, special features that allow plant to survive in a particular place. Terrestrial, living on land. So as per this chapter, the plants which grow on land are called terrestrial. Aquatic, living in water. Plants which grow in water are called aquatic plants. Deciduous. Deciduous is a quality of some plants in which they shed their leaves during winter months. And such plants are known as deciduous plants, trees that shed their leaves in winter. ऐसे पौधे जो सर्दियों में अपनी पत्तियाँ गिरा देते हैं उन्हें deciduous plant कहते हैं. And opposite to it is evergreen. Evergreen are plants are those which bear leaves throughout the year. They don't shed their leaves during winter months. So wrapping it up is, let me summarize what all we have done in this chapter. Plant shows different adaptation to grow in different habitats. Plants can be seen in different habitat, different places where plants can grow. Plants can be seen on hilly areas, in desert areas, in heavy rainfall, or in plains. So they are the different places where plants grow as per the climatic condition, the kind of soil, or the kind of temperature or rainfall. Terrestrial plants are found on hills. Terrestrial plants. So plants are divided as per growing on land and growing in water. So terrestrial plants are found on hill. These are different places or different landforms where we can have terrestrial plants: on hills or mountains, plains, marshy areas, desert, and areas of heavy rainfall. I have explained you with examples how with special adaptations plants, they grow in these different areas. Next is aquatic plants. They are grouped into three categories: free floating, like water lettuce, fixed floating like lotus and water lily, and submerged like duckweed or hydrilla. So they have their own special feature because of which they can survive in water. Plants also have some adaptation to protect themselves from enemies. Some plants, they secrete some kind of juice or some kind of liquid which is poisonous in nature, which help them to protect themselves from other animals. And some plants, they bear thorns or spines on their body, because of which animal do not harm them. So this is all about this chapter. Now the exercise part, I'll be providing you the answer key as well, but let me read all these questions for you all. True or false? The lotus flower grows on land. Lotus plant or lotus flower is an aquatic plant, so it's a wrong statement. It is false. Cacti have big and broad leaves. No, cacti or cactus plants, they don't have broad leaves, they have broad stem. So again, it's a false statement. A large number of leaves help in keeping the big trees cool in summer. Yes, large number of leaves help in keep large and big size trees. These leaves help plants in keeping them cool, like in people and banyan trees. Trees on hill bears cone instead of flowers. Yes, it is true. They don't have flowers. Instead of flowers, they have cones. They are the woody structures. Babool. So it's a true statement. Babool plant grows in water. False. Babool is a desert habitat, desert plant, and it grows in sandy areas where very less rainfall is there. Next is some MCQs for the practice. You need to choose the right option. The place where a plant lives and grows is called its options: habitat, plains, habit, environment. So habitat is the right answer. Okay. The plants growing and living in water are called plants growing in water. They are aquatic plants. Okay. Leaves of fixed floating plants have, now you need to remember the special adaptations of these plants: stomata on their upper surface, stomata on both the surface, stomata on their lower surface, no stomata. So the right option is stomata on their upper surface, because their leaves are very broad inside size and they spread over the surface of the water. So their under surface is in touch with the water, so that's why they have stomata on their upper surface, and lotus is the example. Give two examples of the following. I'm sure you all can do this. Two examples of plants growing in hilly areas, they are cedar and fir. Plants with broad leaves, you can answer people and banyan tree. Fixed floating plants are lotus and water lily. Desert plants, babool and cactus. Identify the following plants. A plant which has breathing roots. Mangroves are the examples. Okay. And they grow in marshy areas. A plant that bears cone. Fir are the plants they bear. They are found in hilly areas. Okay. A plant that has spines. You can name any cactus plants like babool or rose, you can say. A plant that has no stomata. Duckweed is the right answer. Submerged or underwater plants. So one of the example is duckweed, or hydrilla you can also name. An aquatic plant that has beautiful flower. You must be knowing aquatic plant, beautiful flower, lotus and water lily. You can name anyone here. And these are some of the examples. I'll be providing you all the answers to these questions. So, this is all about this chapter. Thank you all.